So check this out. Vitamin E has the ability to inhibit fibrosis. Now, let me just kind of make this more real to you. You can have fibrosis in the lung as scar tissue from all sorts of problems with the lung, whether it's advanced scar tissue in the lung, which is COPD, or maybe you had a series of lung infections which created scar tissue. You could also have like rheumatoid arthritis that can develop scar tissue in the joints. The actual heart tissue called the myocardium can develop scar tissue and inhibit function. The arteries can fill up with scar tissue, making the arteries very, very stiff, raising blood pressure, setting you up for arterial sclerosis. Also, if those arteries go in the brain, it can predispose you to even getting a stroke. Then you have the amyloid plaquing in the brain, which is a protein, which is a type of scar, which is involved with Alzheimer's. And then, of course, the liver. Once the liver becomes fatty and then inflamed, that can turn into scar tissue or fibrosis. So fibrosis or scar tissue is pathological wound healing. There's connective tissue that's replacing functional tissue. So now the function of that tissue doesn't work normally because it's being replaced by scar tissue. Tocotrienols is what I would recommend, which is a certain type of vitamin E. It's actually better than the tocopherols. It's like 50 to 90 times stronger. And the reason for that is that tocotrienols inhibit the collateral damage from white blood cells trying to heal the area. Now, in past videos, I talked about the immune system having a function of defending against pathogens, microbes, viruses, right? I've also talked about the function of the immune system killing cancer cells and shrinking tumors. But the immune system has a third function, and it's involved very intimately in wound healing. Anytime you have inflammation and wound healing, you have the immune system, you have the white blood cells. And it's the collateral damage, the free radicals, the oxidation that's being produced by your own immune system that's creating the excessive damage in scar tissue. So when the white blood cells are releasing massive amounts of cytokines, which are inflammatory and it's creating all sorts of collateral damage, then you get scar tissue. So tocotrienols can neutralize those free radicals. It can counter that effect. It can inhibit fibrosis. So if you have an inflammatory condition, I would highly recommend take this before it turns into the scar tissue or fibrosis, because the problem is once it becomes to a certain level, it's very difficult, if not impossible, to reverse it. Now, the dosage I would recommend per day would be at least 300 milligrams. If you have a lot of inflammation, you can take more. Maybe you could take this 3 times a day. I don't recommend taking the tocotrienols with the tocopherols, okay? Because sometimes the tocopherols can slow down the effectiveness of the tocotrienols. All right, thanks for watching. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to answer everyone's call, but I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.